because no one's ever caught one doesn't mean they're not real.
That is very true, but perhaps they don't wish to be found. I've heard they're rather fierce.
Yeti only look fierce. They probably don't like being so cold all the time. I shouldn't like it either.
You never have to be cold, my Lara, if you don't want to be.
Look!
Henry, what's happened?
Lady Croft,
I've been looking for certain artifacts. Well, for some time now. And an old friend working in the palace has tipped me off about a rather promising rumor.
What sort of artifacts?
An ornate stone dais, among other things.
A big rock, and she won't say why.
Oh, well. Where would the suspense be otherwise? Works, if that's what you're wondering.
Cool. They said it was waterproof. You should be able to swim with it, no problem. Unless you eat it, then you'll have to wait an hour.
It's going to make me sick if you keep on swinging, Lara.
Look away from the screen, then. Deep breath, Sip. This will be a long trip otherwise.
I forgot you were such an optimist.
But I don't see no climber. Yeah, well, I can't shoot on sight if I can't see nobody. I got worked up thinking I'd put someone down today. And now there's nothing. He owes me one. Hell yeah, I'll tell Rutland myself. You know
it. Any idea who he is or who he works for?
I haven't the foggiest. He's deliberately unremarkable.
Is that good or bad?
It's deliberate, which isn't good.
There seems to be a fine line between coincidence and irony.
You sure about that map?
Unfortunately, there was some nonsense about the discovery of the real King Arthur's tomb here years ago, soon discredited. And yet another roadside attraction was born.
Well, let's see what we can see, shall we? At least it should be educational. Either housekeeping should be fired, or no one's been inside for months. They must be electric. I'll have to find the power main.
The place is locked up pretty tight on the ground floor. Probably have to try up higher.
Now this is familiar enough. No King of England jokes, Alistair. I probably have to turn on the power first. This place has seen better days.
It's been condemned since the death of the owner, one Professor Worth. I shudder to think that at one time he had students.
And we have power.
Hey, now that the power's on, maybe you can go back and pull out Excalibur.
It's not Excalibur! The sword in the stone and Excalibur were two different bloody swords! Arthur got Excalibur after the sword in the stone broke in his battle with Pelennor! Oh, good grief, nobody gets it straight!
That's because nobody cares.
Boys.
Sorry.
There's no difference between stupid and charming with you, is there?
And what of Excalibur, ye mighty sword of legend? 'Twas Merlin who did...
Roman fascist that Alistair believes the whole legend was built around. This is where the truth behind the myth is supposed to be explained, and it's been turned into a warehouse.
Fitting. There's been so little truth everywhere else, why start here? The only factual basis behind the King Arthur myths died centuries before this place was built.
Give Professor Worth some credit. If he had to close an exhibit for renovations, at least he picked the most boring one. This definitely isn't Arthur's tomb.
We knew that already.
What's wrong with it?
I've seen enough tombs in my life to know when everything's a cenotaph.
Say who?
A diversion. This place is trying too hard. It's hiding something.
A body?
No, that's the problem. This is better.
Nice. Be careful. You don't want to demolish anything important.
Really, Alistair? I have a velveteen touch. But I'm glad to see you now think there may be something important here. Door. decided to take the slow way down instead.
Should have told that to the forklift.
It's authentic enough for its age, but its age isn't entirely authentic.
And what does that mean? She's saying that the sarcophagus is from around the 11th century, which is when the Arthurian myths were invented. The real Arthur came 5 centuries before, so it's old, but, well, not old enough.
It could be anyone in here, if there's anyone at all. No, there has to be something else here. This will take some concentration.
Yeah, pipe down, Alistair. Or I won't let you sit up front with me anymore.
Thank you. We're looking at myth, except it's real. They're all here, the court of Camelot.
You're sure about this? King Arthur, who wast verily of ye loins of Usurp and Dragon?
I've no doubt about the authenticity of this tomb, Alistair. Arthur was the 11th century figure that became legend. The once and future king was as real then as the air I'm breathing now.
I don't know, Laura.
Excalibur, the sword in the stone. That's how it always goes, isn't it?
Pardon?
Swords in stones, Alistair. They're part of the monomyth. There wasn't just one Excalibur or one Merlin. We keep seeing swords and daises all over the world because they were everywhere.
So you're saying that everywhere they went, they raised up kings, shaping the course of human destiny?
Well, it's a possibility.
Who? And what happened to them and their swords?
Perhaps they're in Avalon. It's as good a place as any. Except our Merlin was killed and our Excalibur was left in pieces in the hands of the locals.
So where's Avalon?
I don't know. On the other side of the looking glass, perhaps? It says Bedivere returned a fragment of Excalibur to Arthur after the other pieces were carried off by the knights.